Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieco and today I'm gonna be showing you how to create super realistic shadows of swinging branches for your interior, and it looks like this. Yeah, I drew that when I was 4. So the technique that we're gonna be using today is a gobo shadow. Gobo is practically you putting something in front of your light, and that thing casts shadows, etc. In our case, we're gonna be putting tree branches, but hear me out. We're gonna be creating our own branches. So what I did, I went outside and I recorded this. Just go outside, point your camera to the sky. If you have some wind or something, try to capture some nice leaf blowings. I created a couple of these. Next, fire up your video editing software. In my case, I'm gonna be using After Effects. So how do you convert this to alpha so that you can use it as a gobo? Click on your video here, go to effects and presets, type hue and saturation. So double click on that and we're gonna decrease the saturation to minimum. Next, we're gonna add levels. Let's double click on that. And we're gonna crank these levels so damn high so that they literally look like alphas. As you can see here, this is practically it. Whoops, I forgot to turn on my pointer for my mouse. Anyhow, whenever you're tweaking the levels here, try to be careful with them because they can easily eat up details. As you can see here, there's some branch visible, but if you turn the levels down a little bit, you can actually see there are more branches here. So just try to go barely to the point where you just don't see the clouds and everything just looks like an alpha. So I'm gonna increase the gamma a little bit and just tweak it like this. I think this is fine. Okay, next, we need to invert this image so that the trees are white and our sky is actually black. So let's type invert. Okay, now you can tweak this as much as you want, maybe a little bit of this, and this is generally fine. Okay, next thing, as you can see, our format here is like a vertical format, and when you think long term, if you create a bunch of these, I doubt that you're gonna remember what aspect ratio did you use for your gobos, etc. So what I like to do, I like to make this square so that I just don't have to think about it. So I'm gonna right click right below my layer and go to composition settings, and here I'm gonna unlock the aspect ratio and I'm just gonna type my height to be 1080 pixels. And this is practically what we got. Now from this point, I can just move it up and down just to choose which part do I like the best. Let's say something like this, and this is the result that we got. I think this is nice and realistic movement. Now let's render it out. Now go to composition, add to Adobe Media Encoder. Once it loads up, go here where it says H.264 and change that to JPEG. Go to the folder where you wanna save this. I'm just gonna name that leaves one. Hit save and click on render. Once your rendering is finished, go into your max, and this is the scene that I have. So first thing, create a plane. Because our output is square, I'm just gonna make this like 300, something like this. Okay, create a bitmap and let's load our leaves. Okay, once our leaves are loaded, plug them into the opacity and plug that material onto our plane. Next, just rotate the plane however you like. I'm gonna position it just in the direction of the sun. So if my sun is going in this direction, my plane is also gonna be shooting in the similar direction. Place it somewhere near the window. Let's lift it up and let's check out what we got. Okay, so we can instantly see some shadowings of the leaves. Now to tweak these, you might wanna go to your sun and just decrease the sun size if the sun size is too high. So let's decrease this to something like, I don't know. Yeah, 0.7, I think that works fine for F-Storm. You can even go lower, like 0.4. It really depends on how much of the leaves you wanna see. And because we loaded this whole texture as a sequence in our bitmap, it's gonna be automatically converted to IFL file, which means that it's gonna load in a full sequence of images, meaning it's gonna load up practically a video footage. And when you scroll through your timeline, you can see that all these leaves are constantly changing, and when you render it out, you're gonna end up with something like this. Sorry, just to mention, for camera movement in my little video, I use this app called CamTrack AR. It's for iOS, and you practically just record your movement with your phone and it tracks your movement, converts it into FBX, and you can import it in your Mac, and you're gonna get realistic kind of camera movement in the whole thing. And the last thing that I really need to mention is our dear, lovely Evermotion, because they have Arc Interiors, Volume 42, two scenes of city and the beach. I don't know if you've seen those. These really look nice. So get this, 20% off, you get the city, all these props. You look, you get a bike, trees, cars, everything. So you buy the package and you get all of that and you get the beach, the bushes, the grass, rocks, palms, buildings in the back, whatever you need. I think this is a fantastic package and it's 20% off. Head over to Evermotion website, check it out. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. See you in the next one. Bye.